and be glad in it. We have some announcements this morning. Council meeting November 8th. Thanksgiving meal had been canceled. Or maybe we can work out something. First request goes out to the Kema Ohana. Julian Wagai is catching up on her personal affairs. John Kalahoy Jr. recovery. Tammy Elikai treatment. Jonathan Stockton recovery. Are there any more announcements that you would like to share with us this morning, Nani?
Yes, I do.
Okay, come. Tell us.
Yes, mahalo nui e ra, mahalo nui e oko e mai ana I ke ia kakahi aka. No laila na, ni lo I ke ia la. A reminder, everyone, we will be cleaning church next Sunday, which is the 7th. We normally like to get it done before the holidays, before Thanksgiving, and definitely before Christmas, so we can put our tree up. So we're starting ahead of time. So next Saturday, which is the 7th, we'll be doing church cleaning. Am I correct, Noy?
Saturday,
7th. We did have plans for our Thanksgiving meal, but that has been canceled. So we will just have our Thanksgiving service. Please come. Reminder. Other than that, mahalo. No more announcements from me. Let us begin our call to worship. Join me, please, with our call to worship. It is very important, and we have the English right below it. Following our call to worship, we will do our Nahimene Mele. You can find that in our Nahimene Puke, which is our brown book, on page 28. Kaumai ke aloha. Shine, Jesus, shine. What a beautiful day for that. So let us begin. Ho ako ako amako I mua o ke alo o ke akua ko kako ho ala. E ho o makau kau a I mua o mako na mea o ke ola me ka make. And let us all say, we have gathered in the presence of God, our Creator, who sets before us the ways of life and death.
For the song, we'll sing the three verses in the Nahimene in Hawaiian. Please try along with us. And then we also have a paper here. Let me give this out to you guys.
Thank you.
we had to go and do a trunk or treat. So the cars came by and we put it inside the trunk. And only at the very end we had the guys come in. How much of these did you get? Did you get one of these bags and one of these bags? Isn't that awesome? And how about you, Aloha? You guys many? Yeah, so I don't think Daddy has to get any more bags, but we'll just stick them right here for now. I want to show you this. Can you come down? Come and with me. Oh, you're too shy. Okay. I'm going to talk to you guys if you can hear us, okay? You see this book? Can you read that one? That says Arizona. You see that one on the wall? Uncle's going to go to Arizona in a few weeks at the end of the month for Thanksgiving. And I got this book from the library, where Auntie Nani was. And the reason why you have the travel book before you go to the place is so that you can get the information from the people who have gone there.
You can sit down. You can sit down. You want to sit down and make yourself comfortable?
You like standing. Okay. So, anyways, what ends up happening is inside of the Arizona book, you see the pictures of the Grand Canyon? They have all the pictures of the places you can visit. And the people already take the pictures, they already visit the places, so that when I go, I can take advantage of what they already experienced. And you know what? We have the Bible. And the Bible is the guidebook for what Jesus gave us. Because you know what? Jesus already has been to heaven. That's where he lives. And when he came to earth, he explained to us, just like this book, what heaven is like and where we're going to go and be with him. Jesus says, in my Father's house there are many mansions. Can you believe that? You have a mansion, Allah. You have a mansion, Pedro. And Jesus is going to prepare those places for you. And when you go and visit him in heaven, he's going to say, hey, welcome to your mansion that I prepared for you. And that's why we study the Bible, because one day we're going to be with Jesus and we're going to get to see the place that he has prepared for us. Does that make sense? A little bit? Still thinking about it. I'm going to let you take this back to your chair, okay? You take that back to your sister. And I'm so glad you guys came out from Laura Fisher, for example. So grateful for you guys to come out and take part. Let's say a quick prayer over our cake this morning. And you want to tell us if you can be a little more clear what that was about, so we'll take the time to explain it. Father, we thank you for your word. We thank you for sending us your son, Jesus, so that we would know what you were like. And Father, that we would also know what your kingdom is like. And Father, we thank you that we're just here temporarily. And Lord, I pray that the kids, sometime in their upbringing, they will understand that actually earth is not our home, but that heaven will be our eternal home. And that what we do now in the way we follow Jesus and we learn to love Jesus is going to affect how we enjoy our eternal home in heaven. So Father, we pray for your blessing, we pray for your protection on them. Lord, I pray that they wouldn't do too much hanging too fast. Lord, I pray that this will be a time when families are strengthened. Father, that there would be a good relationship.